Anyone who works with electronic systems or components will frequently encounter the words analog and digital. What exactly do these words mean and why it is important for us to learn about it? The physical environment in which we live in characterized by analog quantities, that is quantities that change in a continuous manner. Temperature, for example, position, wind speed, light intensity, colors and even my voice or sound wave here are examples of analog signals. When we use a plot to visually represent the values of these analog quantities, it will have varying values over time. It is not simply high or low, exist or not exist, light or dark, white or black. There are always values in between it. This is what we call analog. If the world is an analog place, why do we hear so much about digital technology these days? How can we speak of a digital revolution if the human experience itself is still fundamentally analog? It turns out that analog signals are prone to interference, making our sound sound noisy and the television image aesthetic of it. Thus, to improve the signal quality, the engineered system are store, transmit and process information using signals that are restricted to two values only, on and off, otherwise known as 1 and 0. Whatever values in between these two values here, the 1 and 0, will be considered as either 1 or 0 or either on or off. And this is what we call a digital signal. This mathematical construct is translated into the electronic domain using digital circuitry in which voltages are always high or low. Analog integrated circuits or the IC itself contains the same basic components, transistors, diodes and passive elements like capacitors, resistors and so on. In analog ICs, these transistors are intended to amplify a small unreadable signal like heat or temperature to become more readable value so that we can produce a signal that can be converted into the digital signals. This is what we were going to learn in this course, the circuitry to amplify these signals, these analog signals, for the use in the digital era, in digital area. You will start by learning the theoretical characteristic on how actually a diode can function in chapter 1. Then you will analyze the operation of basic silicon diode in chapter 2. And different types of diode exist in this world will be covered in chapter 3. And after that, we will continue to learn the theoretical characteristics of one of the basic transistors, just the basic transistors, which is the bipolar junction transistor or the BJT in chapter 4. And then we will start to operate it. After we know the theory, then we will operate it in chapter 5 by supplying it with a DC power supply or direct current. And finally, we end this course by making a practical amplifier circuit with AC or alternating current signals in the chapter 6. So all 6 chapters all together, where all these knowledge will be tested in 4 quizzes, which worth 10% of your carry marks. And then we have one midterm test worth 30% of your carry mark, and a final examination worth 40% of your carry marks. The most interesting part is you are not only going to learn this course theoretically, but you will also be going to learn how to construct and test the analog circuit in both your assignment and laboratory sessions, which will contribute another 20% of your carry marks. Hope now you got the idea on what we will cover or what we will learn throughout this whole semester, and hope you are interested in learning this subject. And for further readings, you can get this book here, The Electronics Device, written by Thomas L. Floyd, and also The Electronic Device and Circuit Theory, written by Robert Boyston. So I know you can't wait to learn about this subject. So go on and click the first chapter of this course, which is the basic semiconductor. And if you like this video, hit the like button and consider yourself subscribing to this channel. Stay safe, stay curious, and stay joyful. I'm Ikhwan. May God bless you. Assalamualaikum.